I realized that screaming pain, chilling out in my brain, that I'm going straight ahead with this car.
Ogart! How dare you hunt in our territory? The Sunwalks belong to Thunder Clan.
After tonight, this will just be another River Clan hunting ground.
Watch out, more River Clan warriors!
You may swim like otters, but you and your warriors do not belong in this forest.
Ah!
Rah! Ugh! Ah!
Tiger Claw! This is useless. There are too many River Clan warriors.
No, Redtail. Thunder Clan will never be beaten.
Thunder Clan will honor your courage, Tiger Claw, but we cannot afford to lose any more of our warriors.
Blue Star would never expect her warriors to fight against these impossible odds.
Retreat, Thunder Clan, retreat!
River Clan.
How is Mousefur?
Her wounds are deep, Blue Star. But she's young and stung. She will heal quickly.
And the others?
They will all recover too.
We are lucky to not have lost any of our warriors this time. You are a gifted medicine cat, Spotted Leaf. I am deeply troubled by tonight's defeat. ThunderClan has not been beaten in its own territory since I became leader. These are difficult times for our clan. The season of New Leaf is late, and there have been fewer kits.
There will be more kits when Greenleaf comes.
Perhaps, but training our young to become warriors takes time. If ThunderClan is to defend its territory, it must have warriors as soon as possible.
Are you asking StarClan for answers?
It is at times like this. We need the words of ancient warriors to help us. Has StarClan spoken to you?
Not for some wounds, Blue Star. It was a message from StarClan. Fire alone can save our clan.
Fire? The fire is feared by all the clans. How can it save us?
I do not know, but this is the message StarClan has chosen to share with me.
You have never been wrong, Spotted Leaf. StarClan has spoken, then it must be so. Fire will save our clan.
Rusty?
Hello, Smudge.
You're not going into the woods, are you?
Just for a look.
You won't get me in there. It's dangerous. Henry said he went to the woods once.
He's hardly been beyond the Sharon Garden wall since his trip to the vet.
No, really. He caught a wobbin in there.
Well, if he did, it was before the vet.
Now he's just complaining about birds because they're disturbing his sleep.
Henry told me there are all sorts of dangerous animals out there. Huge wildcats who eat live rabbits for breakfast and sharpen their claws on old bones.
Don't worry. I won't stay long.
Well, don't say I didn't warn you.